Since I was a little kid, I always knew I was going to do this. I knew, I think from like 10 years old, I was going to draw, you know, for the rest of my life, and there was no like question about it. So I guess any advice I'd say is if you're going to, like if you want this at all, if you have any kind of passion of drawing or, you know, living off anything you love to do, you know, do it. You can do anything, and you don't even have to go to school for it.
My way I made it happen was just not stopping, you know? If you like something, just keep doing it, and you can make it happen.
I've been traveling a lot to Japan and Singapore and Thailand and stuff, so each place I go, I kind of pick up like new ideas or inspiration or, you know, different images and stuff. So then I'll add those to the next like, series of whatever I'm working on.
Henry Darger, Sigmar Pulp, some Warhol, and then just a lot of old commercial art from the 80s and 60s and 70s, whether it's commercial art being photography in advertisement or commercially drawn illustration from that era. It's just really respected because there was more attention to detail in that era.
I just started with a new line, a new clothing line called 12 Grain. So I'm just kind of trying to get that going a lot more, and I'm working on animation, a new like animation movie. So it's going to be like 30 minutes, but it's going to take the next like 2 years, so it's going to be long.
I have a book coming out through Upper Playground in the spring. I have a show in San Francisco at the 5024 SF Gallery in August. So those are my main two focal points. When I get back, that's all I'm going to be working on, finishing the book and getting ready for my show. Get the fuck out my way, because I'm slaying 7 MCs today with no delay. Oh, by the way, because this lyric is on, right? Make sure that the rhythm is real, right? So as I'm rolling my endo into the band, I'm feeling...